It's been so long, long hard days. They don't say God's changed my ways, changed my ways, those evil. So I set out, cross that way, strike them down to make them pay and change their ways, their evil ways.
That time of year again. Temperatures drop, leaves changing. That's what the boys been training all year for. That's right, it's bear season.
It's about healed up.
I looked at it there. It
healed
up good, didn't it?
Yeah. It was about
the size
of the field.
Them boys must have one local.
That
I said them boys must have one.
What do you think? You want to go up there where we can get turned loose with them?
Yeah, I mean, if we got time, as long as we ain't. As long as they ain't going to mess nothing else up here, got plans of doing.
No, I mean, all it involves is loading the dogs in the machine and going up there and turning them loose, I guess.
Yeah, we can do it. Get good video.
Where you boys go in at, Merle? I don't even know how you go into that place.
When you come around through there and they cut timbers above the road and below the road, both.
Yeah, I think I'm right. Dusty's backing in right here. That wasn't hard, was it?
Mm-mm. I just figured you're probably better off getting started to line something.
What a bar.
She's a little wet. Hey, hush.
Yep.
I know about where it's
me
at.
Me and that youngin' went from right here straight down, and we come out where you stand.
It's almost
the same. And it ain't. It's 300 yards to the road.
Comes that pup back.
Blue pup.
Yeah, they're fixing to cross. They're going to cross right there above the falls, I think.
It's going to be way above. It's going to be right where the big'un crossed.
Well, it ain't far below the cabin. I got the cabin marked.
Yeah, I've got the
right
crossing down there to
file. Right there, posting signs again. Ross, telling that's right.
How about it, Preacher?
The Appalachian path, gang.
So it's going up cross above the
They're down. Crossing up there, pretty
well,
good piece
it.
Above where they did the other day.
That's
my pup, I think. That's Trigger. Come here, Trigger. Come here.
Hey, Mitch.
Go ahead.
I can't get through that gate. Don't guess, can we?
No, you'll have to foot travel it up through there, Mike, if you want to put some behind.
They're going parallel the tree.
How far did they cross above the gates, you think?
Cross. Pretty good tree. Get
you back. Reckon
you ought to just move on around or what? Put you in behind it.
Blows
your mind,
yeah,
didn't
it? Yeah, we should have helped.
Yeah, that's a lot more. I mean, I know the distance too.
They're right below the cabin, wasn't I? I got it marked.
They're going to go up. They're,
gonna
they're
go going up a creek.
Straight out at the mud hole.
I'd say you're right.
I could be sitting right
there. Boy, I might beat that mud hole, wouldn't you?
Damn right.
They're right now at the cabin.
I'd beat that mud hole.
In the creek.
Yeah, boys, I'm not careful about that mud hole.
Yeah. They're
headed like
that's the mud hole.
Yeah, boys, come on, up there that mud hole.
You kill it, man.
I think see it burn.
Oh, okay.
Three miles. went up there and turned. We thought we knowed where to find a track that morning, and we went up there and turned loose. And sure enough, they left out of there screaming, and we put about 12 dogs.
Yeah, I think there was 12 at the tree.
12 or 13 dogs in there. And I had a couple young dogs that didn't go. They ended up coming back, turned them late, loose a little late. So, but anyway, they treed, and it was a pretty short race. It didn't run far, probably
3/4 of a mile, yeah, I'd say.
Something like that. Treed, and then we had a woman that hadn't ever killed a bear. Her husband hunt with us, and it was not far off of a road to get in there, a walking road. You had to walk about a mile, but it was good walking. And these boys went to the tree. Matthew, you can tell you more about it than I can.
Well, we got in there on the first tree, and the bear was sitting pretty decent, and all the dogs were doing good. But while we were waiting on her to get in there to where she could kill the bear, it actually come down and made a little loop and got a little rough with the dogs for a minute, but then they put him back up another tree pretty quick, and that time it held on till we could get the...
All right, here we go. Doing a little sweating. We got the dogs turned loose about 45 minutes ago, and they didn't go hardly nowhere. And we've got one up a tree. We've got a lady coming in here. It's gonna be her first bear. And we should be able to put this all on video. Dog's doing a good job. We're got a couple boys at the tree, and we're fixing to make our way on in there. I'm waiting on my cameraman. He's coming. Beautiful day. Beautiful leaves. Good time to be in the woods. Thank the Lord.
Well, about that, the camera guy is a little out of shape, overweight. Yeah, he ain't doing too good. I was running way behind. I was giving it everything I had, hoofing it up the road, but as luck would have it, got close, and the bear started to come down the tree again, so bring the rain. Here it goes.
Well, Mike was doing the same here. He said, no, wait a minute. And he was holding
the gun.
And
I was standing here with the gun.
I said, it's coming down, and I'd have shot.
Well, she's had if you say, wait a minute, you'd be, well, it's already on the ground. Well,
every time it tried to come down, it was on the backside. Every time.
And then it went back.
It must have smelled us.
She's had one knee replacement. Others got, and I knew that's the biggest bear she ever hit.
Oh, yeah. I seen on the garden that wasn't
there. It's right down there. You go down this way and then that's the creek.
That road's good walking, too.
Oh, yeah. You stay up here.
I was up here in the creek.
You stay up here. You're not be pulling.
It wasn't good when it got on the tail brush. Willie and Molly was the only two we didn't have caught, it hit the ground. I said, the ice is going to be right out. Please get in there.
You want to get that dog lead off of it?
No, man. Make it work. You know what weather, Mike? Boys, get in here. Get your picture, Mike.
Yeah, I love it. JP, you was in there with him. Come on.
We'll get one of you two first.
Come on, JP.
This episode of Appalachian Holler Hunters is brought to you by Bone Collector, Big&J Attractants, Vortex Optics, Mountaineer Outfitters, Bear Archery, NAP Broadheads, Muddy Outdoors, Real Tree, and Hornady Ammunition.
Well, that was one of many successful hunts here in first bear season in North Carolina. Next we're going to show you, we really couldn't wait to show you, people's asked about it. It's the 503 pounder them boys got. Unfortunately, I had work. I wasn't able to be with them that day, but them boys was on top of it trying to film what they could with the phones and such. So we'll show you what we do have and see what you think there.
Go bear hunting opening day. We're ready. We're all loaded up. All right, we're gonna be turning loose here in a few minutes. Had a good track on camera. We knew it was a very large bear, one of the best ones we was gonna get to turn on for that year, and sure enough, got the dogs on it. The bear went about a half a mile across the road, and we got to, I got to pack two more dogs on it, and Mitch and a young boy were coming in there to try to kill it, and I had a couple people from Alabama with me that were hunting with us, and the bear ended up going on around and treed for just a few minutes. We got a little video of that.
Grab a dog.
Gotcha.
I got the red dog.
And then it didn't stay up a tree very long, come down and our buddy Chris Wiseman got to put the kill shot on it. We didn't get it on video, but a very nice bear, 503 pounds. Yeah, bear of a lifetime.
Yeah, it was a good one, for sure. We ended up having 10 or 11 dogs on it, I think.
One dog cut just a little bit, not bad.
Had a couple holes in one or two of them, but nothing.
It was a good day.
Nothing life-threatening. Probably took us, from the time we turned loose till he killed, it was probably hour and a half.
Yeah, for a big bear, it was a short race. Yeah, it was a good deal.
They jumped it probably 500 or 600 yards from where we found the track, and it was just a steady roar the whole time. And it would bay up, and then it'd move a little bit, bay up and move a little bit, and it finally got in some real rough rocks and some laurel, and that's where he stayed until Wiseman was able to get in there and get his business done.
Yep.
We just turned loose about an hour and a half ago on a big one, and we got him bayed up, and we've already got him shot. So we're headed around to catch some dogs and help get the bear out. I was just going to give y'all a little view of what hunting in my hometown looks like. And we killed him way up in there and to the right. Thank you, Lord, for this beautiful day. Got a big one here on the ground. Gonna be over 400. Trying to get it out. It's a little steep here. Going straight up. In a little steep country here. We get him out. Good size bar.
Well, I reckon that'll do it for this episode. We was excited for bear season here. We didn't get a whole lot of footage. There's most of us is more focused on deer season, as you'd have it. But we got second season coming up. We got some special guests coming. It's going to be a blast. We got another bear episode or two up our sleeve, a first season. And like I say, second season is going to be a doozy. We got a ton of episodes ready to go. We've got a ton of deer hunting left, rabbit hunting. We've got it all. You stay tuned. Keep in check with us. We got some good stuff to show you. I'm gonna close your door back. I didn't close it good.
You got that Rona, do you, son?
No, I got choked.